Recording. Yeah, I'm recording.
I'm scared.
You're recording this, Owen?
Yeah.
It's too late.
How do I zoom in on only your screen? Okay.
Okay, you're going?
Double clicking.
Yeah. Okay.
Right, please enter your name.
Wait, okay, we have to pull down this. Fucking kill me. Oh, God. Oh, I hope they say it.
Hey!
I'm scared.
Oh, no. Oh, that's enter does that. Okay. Oh, I see an annoying girl running toward me from the distance, waving her arms in the air, and she's totally oblivious to any attention she might draw to herself. That girl is Sayori, my neighbor and good friend since we were children.
Ah.
You know, the kind of friend you'd never see yourself making today, but it just kind of works out because you've known each other for so long. I'm Craigie. We used to walk to school together on days like this, but starting around high school, she would oversleep more and more frequently, and I would get tired of waiting up. Owen, is this recording audio too?
Yeah.
Good. But if she's going to chase after me like this, I almost feel better off running away.
I mean, it should be.
However, I just sigh and idle in front of the crosswalk and let Sayori catch up to me.
I overslept again.
Oh, great. You know you're going to have to use that the whole time.
But I got you this time!
Oh, there we go. Hold on, let's make her a death metal.
That's you. That's you.
It's fucking kill me.
You can do that.
Only because I decided to stop and wait for you.
Oh, you say like you were thinking you were ignoring me.
Okay, that's gonna kill your voice.
It will.
Who cares?
Hey, who cares, right?
That's mean, fucking kill me. Well, if people stare at you for acting weird, then I don't want them to think we're a couple or anything. I'm gonna save.
Fine.
Save.
Oh my god. Yeah, just good. Take a little snapshot, return.
But you didn't wait for me after all.
Yeah, so what about it? Doesn't mean I like you or anything.
Guess you never need to be mean, even if you want to.
Whatever you say, Sayori! This is fucking terrible. We cross the street together and make our way to school. As we draw near, the streets become increasingly speckled with other students making their daily commute, like a cum stain on the earth.
By the way, kill me.
God damn it.
Sir!
I don't care.
Club to join you.
Why do you use the light Discord? You're disgusting.
Club? Hold on. Fine. You know what? You wouldn't fucking do this? I change it.
It doesn't go like this.
I use light.
It always
goes
like
this. You're both heathens.
Like this.
How do I do
only
it?
Villains like that. Owen. God, I dropped my kalimba!
Owen.
What? What?
Dude,
no, I don't.
I too have a kalimba. You want me to go get it?
Yo, hold up. Let's do a duet.
Dude, yes, hold on. Okay, just like, entertain whoever would be watching.
I have one subscriber and it's myself. So me, I know you'll like this.
Kalimba.
Kalimba is an African hand piano created by the Africans.
Really?
Really? That's a good one, though.
I told you already. I'm not really interested in joining any clubs.
No. Yes, I'm doing his voice. Who wants to do the other girl's voice?
I think we'll just add people along the way
for
characters.
Yeah, already. I'm ready for this. Oh, testing. 1, 2. I'm gonna die.
Do you?
Tried to open Minecraft.
I just.
Are you alright?
Yeah.
I want a coffee. I'm gonna go get me some coffee.
Drinks coffee. Fucking music. Age restricted. This one.
Are you 13 years or older?
This game just said.
No, I was going to find the Wimba, and then I realized that I can't find it, and also I could be playing Doki Doki Literature Club right now.
Ryan left though.
I told you already, I'm really not interested in joining it. Ryan left.
Ryan left, he's like, I gotta get coffee!
He went to get coffee? Don't worry about it.
Bitch! I haven't been looking either.
That's not true!
I'm gonna destroy your voice, do like
no,
a girl.
I'm still doing it, shut up.
No!
Listen, it's okay. It's Columbus Day tomorrow.
Alright, save.
You haven't done anything yet, there's nothing.
Now that that's done.
Did I?
I'm sure it's possible that I did, in one of our many conversations where I dismissively go along with whatever the fuck she's on about.
Those eyes, though.
of his eyes.
Sayori likes to worry a little too much about me when I'm perfectly content just getting by on the average while spending my free time on games and anime. Sounds like me.
Weird.
Sounds like...
It has to be relatable somehow.
It's relatable.
I'm worried that you won't learn how to socialize or any skills before college.
That also sounds like me.
That's not your job, Sayori.
Well, you know. Your happiness is really important to me, you know.
Dude, her hands are so small.
Maybe it's your hands.
Like, what?
I thought I'd love you coming up neat in a few years because you're not used to the real world.
I can't remember what that stands for.
Non-existent extraterrestrial teenager. Yes, it's Sea Bear.
Continue reading.
Oh, Ryan came back.
No, it's Sea Bear.
Right.
No, it's Chris.
Sea Bear. This is our Let's Play of Doki Doki Literature. He's gone. What?
Don't make me keep worrying about you.
All right. I'll look at a few clubs if it makes you happy. Specifically the Doki Doki Literature Club, I assume.
Oh.
Same.
Wow.
The fuck is all this, Rubenstein?
Oh, yo, is that Garrett?
Yeah.
Well, who cares? We're busy.
Tell him to join the Doki Doki.
Well, at least promise you'll try a little.
Nope! Yeah, I guess I'll promise you that. But little did you know, I was gonna go home and masturbate to boys.
I just got back.
Welcome back, Kami.
Why do I let myself get lectured by such a carefree, girl?
It's because she has no nose.
I'm an anime character, and I like women, but I also hate being around women. And more than that, I'm surprised I even let myself relate to her. I hate women. I guess seeing her worry so much about me makes me want to ease her mind at least a little bit. Even if she does exaggerate everything inside of her head. Like my size. The school day is as ordinary as ever, and it's over before I know it.
Wait, we don't even get to see the school day? Wow.
There's no words on the papers.
After I pack up my things, I stare blankly at the wall, looking for an ounce of motivation. But it's a wall. Clubs. Sayori wants me to check out some clubs. I guess I have no choice but to start with the anime club.
Your next person comes on screen.
I mean, I'm just going in alphabetical order, guys.
I promise. Hello?
Sayori, get out! I don't know. Sayori must have come into the classroom while I was spacing out.
I just the laugh.
I look around and realize that I'm the only one left in the classroom. Uh-oh, everyone left!
I look at the clock and it's 7:45 at night.
So I came in.
Oh my god. I have no sense of personal space!
Honestly, you're even worse than me sometimes. I'm impressed.
Well, you shouldn't be.
God, it's cold in here.
Friendship.
Why is she already has no boobs. Why is she wearing like a compression vest?
Pain.
Anyway,
it's legally mandated.
For me if it's gonna make you late to your own club. I can just like go and be in the going home club.
Well, I thought you might need some encouragement, so I thought, you know.
I'd give you a hand job. No, what?
Well, that you could come to my club.
Oh!
Good job, club. Sayori, that club's for
me. Yeah.
There's no way I'm going to your hand job club.
Meanie.
Well, for starters, hand jobs are the worst form of foreplay. They're
like
fucking boring.
Of the literature club.
Not if you don't make them.
I was ever aware that she had any interest in hand jobs. Okay, I'm telling you, it's a metaphor for hand jobs. If you just replace literature with hand jobs, it becomes a metaphor for hand jobs.
Doki Doki hand job club.
Exactly. In fact, I'm 99% sure she only did it because she thought it would be fun to help start a new club. Well, I mean, why would they even put a hand job club in our fucking high school? Since she was the first one to show interest after the one who proposed the club, she inherited the title Vice President.
Why?
Or Grand Poobah of the Indonesian Hand Job Club. That said, my interest in literature.
Well,
is even less.
Oh, God.
Yeah, I'm going to the. Asshole club.
Virgin Club. Virgin Club.
I'm going to the Virgin Club.
Come on, please.
No, I want to keep my... Oh, what is it called? Oh, no. Yo, it's not... I don't want to say virginity, but I want to keep my purity.
Purity's good. Well, I kind of told the club yesterday that I'd bring in a new member.
Well, too fucking bad.
No one likes my voice, though, and Natsuki made cupcakes and
everything. Oh, cupcakes?
She said that if I didn't, you know, bring a new member, I'd just think I'm
gonna end my life.
You know how hard it is to sing happy birthday?
I drop an octave and they just, like, their ears bleed.
Don't make promises you can't keep. Anyway, time to kill myself. I can't tell if Sayori is really that much of an airhead or if she's so coming as to have planned all of this.
Don't worry, I'm both.
But said something else.
I'm actually.
I let out a long sigh.
Oh, my brain hurts.
Oh, sigh. Fine. I'll stop by for a cupcake, okay?
Ha! Hilarious.
Vaginas.
Same.
You mean hands?
Yes, let's go. Oh, God.
Did I just, like, fast forward? What is happening?
I think so. What happened?
Okay.
And thus today marks the day I sold my soul for a vagina. For China. I dejectedly follow Sayori across the school and upstairs, a section of the school I rarely visit, because it's for women, being generally used for third-year classes and activities. And women, am I right, ladies?
My school is segregated, and this is where all...
This is where all the blacks hang out. And I can't be seen with them.
Oh, no.
Sayori, full of energy, swings open the classroom door. Like my sound effect?
Everyone, the new member is here.
I'm a woman. I told you, don't call me a woman. I haven't had the surgery yet, Sayori.
Yeah.
I glance around the room. Who is this?
Welcome to the Literature Club, it's a pleasure meeting you. Sorry, this is a nice thing about you.
Oh, feminist. Hold on, I didn't, sorry.
Oh my god!
Hold on, shut up.
Brian,
seriously, you brought a boy? You way to kill the atmosphere. Oh.
Oh, this is Ryan.
Hold on, we need somebody else. Ryan, do this voice.
I have, what do you...
Anything.
You're this girl. Anime, go.
Oh, fucking kill me, what a surprise.
What a terrible voice.
It's like half Italian.
To the club.
Ellipse.
All words escape me in this situation.
Except the
this club is full of incredibly cute boys.
What?
What are you looking at? Do you want to say something? Say it. Sorry, it's just you don't have any.
You're only 4 feet tall. Nuts!
I'll do the red.
I fucking love your face. A girl with a sour attitude whose name is apparently
Natsuki
is one I don't recognize. Probably because she's too fucking short. I'm right! We think she's probably a dwarf.
Got him.
And I don't like things that aren't regular people. She's also the one who made cupcakes, according to Sayori.
Sayori. I'll do this too.
Well, that's because that is...
That is your voice!
Don't worry about it, shut up.
Jack, remember your lines!
Says that quietly into my ear, then turns back toward the other girls.
I'll whisper that. Anyway, this is Natsuki, always full of energy.
Wait, do I have a name yet?
And this is Yuri, the source of the club.
My name is Yuri. Oh. Don't say things like that!
Yuri, who appears comparably more mature and timid, seems to have a hard time keeping up with people like Sayori and fucking bitch over here.
Small.
Well, it's nice to meet both of you. I can't talk to women because I'm an anime.
Monica! Lewinsky, get over here!
I'll
I'll do this on the
side. Is that like a stripper? Did they just add a stripper to the club? It's like, girl power, here's a stripper.
And now, the one under the desk over there is Monica.
Right, can you do it?
You want me to do a German accent?
German, fuck it.
That's alright.
Oh my god, you sound like a gay.
That's the point.
Oh Hans, you're so deep in mein Schwarzkeller.
Okay, continue.
It's great to see you again, fucking kill him. Me.
Why is the I capitalized?
Fucking kill, I don't know. I meant to capitalize the K, but I was typing the I.
Good job.
Manicus Swale!
What the hell is she doing? Just like, go!
And also summons wind to blow her skirt up.
Dude, that's like a freaking JoJo.
Wait a minute.
I'm sorry.
Monica is the stand.
Dude, that's a JoJo stand.
That's a JoJo stand.
Standmaster Sayori. Stand name Monica.
We do know each other. Well, we rarely talk, but we were in the same class last year.
We don't know each other.
Monica was probably the most popular girl in class. Smart, beautiful,
aesthetic.
Basically, completely out of my league.
My name is fucking Killnit.
So having her smile at me so genuinely feels a little
orgasmic.
Oh yeah.
You too, Monica.
Come sit down, fucking kill me. I made room for you at the table so you can sit next to me, or Monica.
Ooh, is this the first choice?
In right away by shooting their pheromones all over me and doing weird dances.
I can't tell if you've clicked. Okay.
I'll get the cupcakes.
Oh, sorry. Hey, I made them. I'll get them, okay? Step the fuck off, bitch.
Sorry, I got a little too excited.
The hell about I make some tea as well? The hell about I make some tea as well?
What the fuck was that, real talk?
Oh my god.
I wanna make some green tea!
Holy shit.
Wait, did you hear Mason in the background dying?
Yo! The girls have a few desks arranged to form a table.
They're all if you look, they're all tables.
As Sayori mentioned, it's been widened so that there is one space next to Monica and one space next to Sayori.
This best be the first choice.
Natsuki and Yuri walk over to the corner of the room where Natsuki grabs a wrapped tray and Yuri opens the closet for me to step out of. Still feeling awkward, I take a seat next to Sayori. I'm not creative. Natsuki proudly marches back to the table, tray in hand. Are you fat? Ta-da!
What?
Natsuki lifts the foil off the tray to reveal a dozen white fluffy cupcakes decorated to look like little
cats.
The only problem is that all of them are burnt.
The whiskers are drawn with icing and little pieces of shit were used to make the ears.
Why do the two people on the side look so distressed about the cupcakes?
Koi desk.
Desk.
Ryan!
I had no idea you were so good at baking, Natsuki.
Natsuki.
How do you win them?
To Montesquieu!
You know? Just hurry and take one! Sayuri grabs the first one, then Monica and I follow. Not you, you little bitch!
It's delicious!
Sayuri talks with her mouth full and has already managed to get icing on her
face. Uh-oh.
Oh, I suck it.
I'm gonna lick it off.
Yeah, we had the same... wavelength. I turn the cupcake around in my fingers, looking for the best angle to take a bite. Ooh, I'm feeling a choice coming up. A choice that will impact the whole game.
Eat cupcake or not.
I have to figure out what angle to bite the cupcake at.
45.
Natsuki is quiet. She doesn't even breathe. She just had a heart attack.
Everyone's in a coma now.
I can't help my... She spiked him! There's roofies in him! Oh, God! Natsuki smiles as we all die. I can't help but notice her sneaking glances in my direction. He has a penis! Oh, no!
I've never seen one of those before.
Not in real life, only on the fucking internet. Oh, my God. Is she waiting for me to take a bite?
Then again, they've been all pixely, I don't even know.
Like, this is almost a metaphor for her snatch. I finally bite down.
Oh god! Oh jeez! You're not supposed to bite it!
This razor blade!
I put drugs in your candy!
Full of flavor. I wonder if she made it herself. Look at his fucking face. She's been staring at you like that.
I wonder why they don't have a nose.
My nose is off-centered.
That's a weird nose.
This is really fucking good. Thank you, Natsuki.
I think I'm dying.
Why are you thanking me? It's not like I made them for killing.
Shoot that up!
Baka! Baka!
Haven't I heard this somewhere
before?
She got even shorter.
I was right! Made them for you or anything. Baka! Shit.
Damn it.
I thought you technically did. Sayori said, whoa. Oh my god, my ear is ringing. Oh, ow, ow, this isn't a joke. Oh, jeez. Okay, there we go. Well, maybe, but Baka!
Your parents home?
I went to the right spot. Not for you, you know, you Baka!
Oh my god.
Shut up! God.
Alright. I give up on Natsuki's weird and dismiss the conversation. Yuri returns to the table carrying a tea set. She carefully places a teacup in front of us before setting down the teapot next to the cupcake tray. You keep a whole tea set in this classroom?
Don't worry, the teachers gave us permission. After all, it does not a cup of tea help you enjoy a good book. Save.
I guess.
Monica.
Don't let yourself get intimidated. Yours is trying to impress you.
Oh, she's such a bad girl. Isn't such a nice girl?
That's not...
Insulted, Yuri looks away from her girlfriend. They're dating. Oh my god, this is a lesbian club.
Of course it is. I meant that, you know, I just really like the bar. I like Munchin Box.
Snatch. I believe you.
You stupid idiot.
Well, tea and reading might not be a pastime for me, but at least I enjoy tea. How does that make any fucking sense?
Wait, what?
Tea's
okay. I really like your tea.
It's not like I like tea or anything, but tea's pretty good.
I'm glad. I'm so glad. Oh my god.
So Yuri faintly smiles to herself in relief.
Pulls out a mirror and smiles.
I like the theory that she's just talking like this because she's so fucking nervous. She's like, can't even speak. Monica raises an eyebrow, then smiles at me. Ryan!
It takes a while to load.
It's kind of stuttery.
So what made you consider the literature club?
I don't know, some fucking bitch. I look over at Sayuri. I was afraid of this question.
I just really like books.
Something tells me I shouldn't tell Monica that I was practically dragged here by Sayuri.
Oh, choice?
I haven't joined any clubs yet, and Sayuri practically dragged me here, so shit! Damn it.
That's okay. Don't be embarrassed.
I just really like young adult novels.
Well, make sure you feel right at home, okay?
Oh.
This present of the literature club, it's my duty to make the club fun and exciting.
It's in his mouth.
He's just slowly getting closer to you.
Stop saving, holy crap, dude.
Monica, I'm surprised.
I will kill you.
Kim, you decided to start your own club. You could probably be a board member for any of the major clubs.
Oh my god.
Weren't you a leader of the debate club last year?
She just teleports. Oh my god.
Ryan, it's your
train.
This is so stupid. Are you flipping a coin?
Oh my god.
I'm good.
Okay, go.
It feels like nothing but arguing about the budget and publicly preparing on how to prepare. Ah! Jesus Christ.
Stay away from the mic.
Get away. Step away from the mic.
Just
away
from my kid. Oh my god, I need a drink.
You think I don't need a drink?
Keep going.
I'd much rather take something I personally enjoy.
Stop.
Make something special out of it.
Oh god.
Now she's serious again.
Stand up straight.
Stand up straight, soldier.
And this video encourages the ass. Don't not slouch. My fucking classroom.
Shot a square.
Fucking gas chamber. You think we fuck around here? We don't fuck around.
Oh, you just got lucky. It's a gas. This is a shower.
It's a shower. Just step into the shower.
And if it's. Oh, Jesus Christ.
Oh, you really is a great leader.
Did I tell you to say anything?
Wait, history.
Friend skip. Yeah, also nods in agreement.
Yeah.
And I'm surprised there aren't more people in the club yet, just to see your tight ass. It must be hard to start a new club.
You would put it that way.
Do you know how many people I killed to get me this club?
Jeez.
Not many people are interested in putting out all the effort to start something brand new.
Do you know how many slaves lived in this room before we took over?
The Third Reich.
We are the fourth fish.
Especially when it's something that doesn't grab your attention. Like genocide.
Like...
Literature.
Wait, what is the literature supposed to be again?
Hand jobs.
I don't fucking know.
Like, these books?
I haven't read a book yet.
You have to... Okay. You have to work hard to convince people that you're both fun and worthwhile.
Don't be stupid, be a smarty. Come and join the Nazi pod.
Well, to make school events like the Holocaust is that much more fun.
Oh yeah.
Oh,
we have one every month.
It's a full
Dude,
Holocaust.
I found like a picture of NASA's taking some anal beads.
Stop.
I'm confident that we can really grow this Reich before we graduate.
Mm.
Right, everyone.
Hi, Monica.
Yeah.
You bet, dude.
See Kyle.
See Kyle.
We'll do our best.
You know that. I just love this club.
Take heal.
Everyone enthusiastically. Wait, what was this fucking voice? Everyone enthusiastically agrees.
I'm like 5'9", 7'6".
Secret girls, all interested in the same goal. All right, I got it back.
But what?
I must have worked really hard just to find these three. And
hey, you cunts want to join.
That's why they were all so delighted by the idea of a new member joining. They all have the same fucking hair color except Yuri.
Yeah.
They all have a different hair color.
I don't know what
you're
talking about.
Their level of enthusiasm about literature or not politics? I don't know. Monica's freaking me out.
So kill me. What things do you like to read about?
The Bible, mostly.
Bible.
Considering how little I've read these books, I don't really have a good way of answering that.
Wow, you're an idiot. That's great.
Manga, Tumblr, Twitter. I'm gonna quietly myself, half joking. Of course, I'm not an idiot.
Oh, she's an otaku.
Natsuki's head suddenly pricks up.
I knew it.
Do you like yaoi?
Oh my god.
I finally got this apple piece I had in my.
How much of a reader, I guess?
Ow.
Well, that's generalized, Yuri.
Well, that could change for a little titty slip, you know? Just a little bit. Just, you know, take it
out. That's all it takes.
What am I saying? I spoke without thinking after seeing Yuri's titties. Anyway, what about you, Yuri on Ice?
Well, let's see.
Yuri traces the rim of her anus teacup with her finger.
But there's no teacup.
My favorite usually novels that build deep and complex fantasy worlds.
So fucking fantasy novels, just say it.
Only deep and complex ones. The level of creativity and craftsmanship beyond them is amazing to me. Oh my god. Telling a good story in such a foreign world is equally impressive.
Sounds fantastic.
Yuri goes on, clearly passionate about fantasy.
Have you ever read the Hunger Games? Oh my god.
You're a little bitch, ain't ya? She seemed so reserved and timid since the moment I walked in, but it's obviously by the way her eyes light up. I love how you, like, got the voice spot on immediately.
It's perfect.
That she finds her comfort in the world of books, not people.
No, I think my voice is perfect.
But you know, I like a lot of things. Like stories of deep psychological... Oh, I like pornography. Oh my god! Oh man. Isn't it amazing how a writer can deliberately take advantage of your own lack of imagination and throw you for a loop? Oh.
I read that as poop.
Anyways, I've been reading out of horror lately.
Oh, you get off soon, big girl.
I
read a horror book once.
Which
I
one?
Went to bed.
5 days.
I went to bed.
I desperately grasped something I could relate to at the minimal level. I played Silent Hill.
I watched it last week.
At this rate, Yuri might as well be having a conversation with a Karak. Crockpot.
Really? I wouldn't have expected that, Yuri.
Yeah, let's
all... You're making your mouth.
Sorry.
You look so, like, scared.
Oh. For someone as gentle as you.
Before we get...
Jesus Christ, I'm saving.
Yeah, man, that was a bit of time.
I guess you could say that.
Oh! So unladylike, I immediately put her out the door.
But if a story makes me think or takes me to another world, then I can't really put it down.
I mean, that sounds pretty close-minded of you.
Surreal horror is often very successful at changing the way you look at the world, only for a brief moment.
I don't think that's true, but whatever.
Not at all. Surreal horror.
Are you a madman?
I hate horror.
Why do you have an hourglass in your hair?
Oh!
It's
so
hard to say horror. I hate horror.
Oh! Why is that?
Because it's scary! Well, I just...
They all are.
Natsuki's eyes dart over to me for a split second.
Dude, my hair is so long. Holy crap.
Jesus Christ, it is. That's right. You should like to write about cute things, don't you, Matsuki?
No,
how do you pronounce that name?
The big black cocks.
Just take out the U and then you're good.
What?
NANI!
What gives you that idea?
What the fuck is that face? You left a piece of scrap paper behind the last club meeting.
Oof.
I stalk you.
I saw a boy on it and a girl on it. She had a penis.
You were working on a poem called...
I like big black cocks in my vagina. That's a pretty on the nose poem there.
How's your game?
The game? Oh, it's great, Mason.
That looks pretty shit to me.
You're right in that assumption.
Fine.
You don't get to talk, Jack.
What is your brother saying?
He said it looks pretty shit, the game.
Yeah.
And then he went to the bathroom. Oh, right, Jack, you get to talk!
Your cupcakes, your poems.
God, you're such a bitch.
Everything you do is just accusing you are.
Oh!
I'm gonna lick your snatch.
Oh, no! Whoa! Oh, we're getting... Oh, no. Ah! Oh, Mahanad. Hi.
Snuggly bitch.
Mahanad, the only reason we're playing this is because the beginning has a warning for people that are disturbed or easily or depressed should not play this game.
So it sounds awesome.
So we're all gonna commit a mass suicide at the same
time. Yeah, I don't know. This is like one of them creepy pastos or whatever you kids are watching now.
Ooh, creepy pasta.
I am not cute. We need to find a voice for Mahanad.
Next character's Mahanad.
Right. Next character's Mahanad.
No, he can be Natsuki.
Yeah.
Oh, next character that comes in.
Yeah,
no,
like
I'm
next
Natsuki.
Character.
I really got the perfect voice.
Yeah, Natsuki's good.
Natsuki, you made your own poems. I sound like a fucking weird, like, California...
That's the wrong... You did the wrong voice.
You did the wrong voice.
Natsuki, yeah, I said, that's what I... Natsuki, you write your own poems, that's what I did.
Eh, well, I guess sometimes...
Oh, this is gonna be a fucking annoying thing. This is one conversation the two people I voice.
What do you care? I think that's impressive for a girl.
Then you hear just sloshing water.
No!
Natsuki averts her eyes.
You wouldn't like them. They're all about...
Boys.
Men.
It's all yours.
Venus.
I'm not a very confident writer yet.
Let me help you with that. I understand how Natsuki's feeling. Sharing that level of writing takes just more than confidence.
It takes balls. Something women don't have.
It takes confidence and balls. The truest form of writing is writing to oneself. Like Tolkien. You must be
writing to one's son.
You must be willing to open up to your readers, exposing your vulnerabilities and showing even the deepest reaches of your heart.
I like men.
Would you have writing experience too, Yuri? Oh shit.
This
maybe
music.
You can share some of your wow. You could set an example and help Natsuki feel comfortable enough to share hers.
Monica, you bitch, let's do it.
Ellipses.
I guess it's the same for Yuri. You're all little bitches. I'll share some of my writing.
All I wanted to read is
what's his dick in his deep cavernous anus. Oh my god, it's like 50 Shades of Grey meets Yuri on Ice.
Do you know how much these ties cost?
What even is this voice I'm doing?
I really want more tea. But lazy to go
oh, I wanted to read everyone's poems.
Yuri's got tea.
I want to brew more tea, but I also don't want to stop.
You can't stop, won't
stop.
Okay.
Just dehydrate.
Once I get to like 9, we'll take like a 10-minute break for everyone to go like freshen up.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, and then I'll stop the recording and we can do multiple parts because I don't know how long.
We all sit in silence for a moment. Only one.
Wait, we need an actual moment of silence. Hold up. Nice. Thank you.
Okay. Are you actually recording this?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, of course he is. Hold on. Oh, and what time are you at right now?
I don't know. I see the green light, so it's all good.
All right. If it's, yeah, but if it's like
20
minutes, then cut it down.
Well, we've probably been doing this for a while, actually. Ooh. Continue. A moment of silence has ended.
Yeah. Well, but if it's like, if it gets too long.
Alright, we'll leave this at this moment of silence. I'll stop the recording. And then.
Yeah, and I'm gonna-